You know, one of the things we've been talking about is sort of the state of the safety net. And this really seems to show some of those cracks really strongly. You have teachers who are underpaid and have been on strike just in recent months. You have private schools that are able to say, you know, oh, they put Zoom on all the kids' iPads, and public schools where they're trying to do Chromebook distribution without exposing more kids potentially to, and their parents, to actual infection. Like, long term, depending on how long this all lasts, do you think that this could expose some of those divides in a way that gets us to do something about it?
Well, I think it has already. We've known for a long time that public schools play a vital role in the social safety net for children in this country. Over half the kids in this country qualify for free or reduced lunch. And for those kids, many of them rely on school for basic nutrition, because it's not just lunch, it's breakfast for many kids. When schools close, they don't have access. And we know that that means that we're going to see more kids not eating regularly. So the stability that schools provide to kids is so critical to their development. And we know now that many kids are even more vulnerable because schools are closing. This is a huge problem that we are not prepared for.
I was having a text exchange with my boss earlier today about this. How long do you think the effects of, and let's just call them the next 2 months, how long do you think those effects ripple through this economy? Because you'll have kids who have lost basically a semester of school.
The impact, it's hard to measure at this point because we don't know, again, how long, and we don't, what parents can do to make up. If parents could keep their kids reading and keep them intellectually engaged at home, then, you know, the gap in learning is probably going to be negligible. But for those parents who don't have the means or resources or time to do so, the kids are going to fall further behind. We've known for a long time, for example, that the kids who are in enriched learning environments in the summer come back to school in the fall way ahead of the kids who've been sitting at home playing video games and or just not involved in any kind of meaningful learning. And we're going to see those kinds of gaps in learning opportunities grow.